Hello, folks. Welcome to Annoyed Gamer. I am Marcus Beer, and oh boy, howdy, do I have a couple of topics for you today. Gonna just crack on into it with the first topic, SimCity. Yeah, if you've basically been living under a rock or not on Twitter or Facebook or NeoGAF or basically anywhere where games are talked about, you will have missed the fact that SimCity launched this Tuesday. To put it kindly, it's probably one of the worst game launches of all time. And it kind of sucks. In fact, it totally sucks because when you do actually get in, the game's fantastic. I mean, it really is a great SimCity game. It's an evolution. There's a couple of things that take a little bit of getting used to, but on the whole, it's a fantastic game. Unfortunately, it's a fantastic game that is surrounded by a moat, nay, a lake, nay, an ocean of pain and shit that is known as the Origin servers. The initial launch wasn't actually too bad. Yeah, it took about 40 minutes from the time the game went live to actually getting in and, you know, getting it downloaded and all that fun stuff because they didn't have the preloading, which is kind of ridiculous this day and age. So that's kind of strike one, but then 40 minutes later I was in. However, after playing for a little while, ooh, disconnect. That's a bit irksome. And then I check my Twitter while I'm trying to log back in, and ooh, lots and lots of people being disconnected. And it's continued. I'm not gonna go absolutely bananas and mental on you. I'm just gonna basically say shame on you, because you knew how many people were gonna want this game. You knew that the PC gamers were gonna be aching for it. You insist on having this always on internet connection to your service, which has been dodgy at the best of times. And you basically screwed it. You screwed it up. There's a reason your Metacritic user score is hovering around the 2 right now, because what is a great game is being destroyed by a shoddy service. And it's not rocket science what you need to do to actually launch a good online game. Now, I know Blizzard have messed up in the past as well, because, you know, times have changed, more and more people are online, you need the always on DRM, connection to servers. So what you do is, you throw up too many servers. You make sure you have server hubs all over the US, and, you know, Europe's just gone live and they're having exactly the same problem. I mean, I've spoken to people who've had 3 hours of access to SimCity since they bought the game on Monday night. But it really pisses me off that, you know, EA have been on the defensive, or actually even the offensive, this week, when they really should be focusing on getting this shoddy ass Origin system up to speed. Earlier this week, Peter Moore decided to come and criticize a website. This website deserved the criticism because they made up a BioWare interview. And Peter Moore went on and was like, yes, I am Peter Moore, and blah, blah, blah. Instead of doing that, Peter, maybe you should be on a plane to Origin's headquarters, where the tech guys are, and basically walk around with those big hands of yours smashing people's heads into desks, saying, why the fuck is our biggest PC launch of this year not working properly? Couldn't you dimwits sort it out? Origin is not up to snuff. It's been broken before, it's majorly broken now. You're gonna kill this game stone dead. Fix it. Segment 2, let's talk about Peter, the People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals, or as I like to call them, pedantic egotists, talking arse. And they have been talking arse again this week. In fact, anytime a video game comes out, almost with any animal connection whatsoever, these little wankers decide to get all uppity and go bananas, even though it's a video game. And what was the topic of their irksomeness, their ire, their just getting their tofu balls in a bunch? It was Assassin's Creed 4. But before I go off and talk about what their latest cock up is all about, let's talk about some of the things they've done in the past. Some of the games they've attacked. Super Meat Boy, they didn't like that because it had meat in it. Battlefield 3, this was interesting. Somebody in Peter, Germany decided to get all up their own ass and getting all excited because you could stab rats in one level with a knife. Well, I suppose, you know, Peter being a bunch of useless rats, they actually feel a kinship with his little rodents. Call of Duty. Call of Duty came under attack because you shoot attack dogs. Well, I don't mean to bust your bubble, but whether it be in a video game or real life, if a dog is coming at me looking to rip my arm off and I have a gun, I'm gonna shoot the fucker as well. It's called self-preservation. I'm not gonna roll over so Lassie can rip up my intestines, thank you very much, in the game space or in real life. And of course, the most famous target for Peter in their, you know, whorish efforts to garner media coverage. In 2011, they went after Super Mario Brothers for the Tanuki suit. Now, I gotta say, your research is so up to date on this. Well done, Peter. I mean, you know, the Tanuki suit debuted in Super Mario 3 in 1990, and it only took you 21 years to figure out it was actually in there. So yeah, good job at just showing yourselves up for the whorish assholes you are. You know what, Peter, I'm not all anti-video game. In 2009, they gave Fable 2 an award for most animal-friendly game of the year. You know, because you could eat celery and lose weight, and so it promoted a vegan lifestyle. But again, not so much with the research, because guess what? That's the same game where one of the first achievements you earn is called Chicken Kicker. Yeah, and you don't get that for eating a breaded piece of Domino's chicken. No, it's for kicking chickens. Yeah, bang up job, guys. All right, so why are the tofu molesters getting all uppity this time around? Well, in Assassin's Creed 4, which we've only seen a video trailer for, and we've had some, you know, interviews, there's a scene, there's a whale, and, you know, there's a harpooning section. So Peter's argument against all this is that it trivializes the hurt that whales endure. Well, I guarantee you, no real whales were hurt in the making of this video game. I'm sure Ubisoft Montreal, they didn't toddle off down to SeaWorld and find an orca and poked it with sharp sticks just to see how it got, you know, bled right. It's a fictional video game. It's a bunch of digital art. It's not real. Get that through your thick skulls. Do some research, get a clue. Now, let's have a quote, because let's face it, I love putting out quotes because then I like ripping people apart. And here's the quote from Peter that they gave to Polygon this week when Polygon reached out to them and said, you know, what the fuck are you guys doing? Now, this quote is from Matt Bruce of Peter's International Grassroots Campaigns. Joe Schmo, who plays the game in his mother's basement in the safety and comfort of his home, will feel a sense of accomplishment by killing this whale. You were annoying and irksome and pretty much out of order before, but now you want to go with the whole Joe Schmo sitting in his basement? This is the M-rated game, and the majority of people who will play this will not be sitting in mom's basement. The median age of a gamer is now in the mid-30s. High disposable income. People who should be supporting Peter, because the overall message of Peter is actually pretty good. We don't want animals to be tortured. We don't want them to be hurt. We don't want factory farming. But look, Peter, as always, view the video game industry as a soft target. And, you know, sometimes a soft target will turn around and slap you back. And Ubisoft did that this week. They responded. The excellently named Stone Chin, who is the senior PR manager for Assassin's Creed, issued a response on behalf of Ubisoft. Obviously, you know, the common sense part of it was, guess what? It's a historical game set in a fictional story, blah, 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 which is true. And, you know, it goes to show how stupid Peter are being. On top of that, he added this zinger. We do not condone illegal whaling, just as we don't condone a pirate lifestyle of poor hygiene, plundering, hijacking ships, and over the legal limit, drunken debauchery. And I guess that really kind of sums it up, to be honest with you. And guess what? Like it or not, animals are part of the food chain. Just like when humans go swimming with great white sharks, we're part of the food chain. Or when we walk off into the jungle and we get eaten by tigers, we're part of the food chain. It's called the circle of life. I know I'm not going to hold up a baby lion cub right now because there's not one a hand. Unfortunately, I'll be accused of being cruel to it. But stand up to these bullies. Let Peter know that they're actually being idiots. Because you know what? If a game like Assassin's Creed 4, where you harpoon a whale, and you see the impact of that, which we may do, we don't know yet. If you see that impact, it makes you think about it. Oh, of course, we are talking about harpooning whales, which is illegal in 90% of the world. You know, if it makes you think about it, great. Why don't you partner with Ubisoft? Why don't you say, let's do some education, let's look at this as a positive tool, instead of jumping to, you know, a conclusion and going bananas. Video games is not an easy target, and never will be, as long as people like me have this show and are willing to come at you and call you out for the monumental cocksuckers that you really are. I'm out. I'll see you next week. Follow me on Twitter. I am @AnnoyedGamer. Let me know if you agree with me, if you disagree with me. And feel free to let Peter know that they're assholes. Be nice to animals. I got no problems with animals. 3 cats, friends with dogs, love animals. And I love the tasty ones even more.
See this and other GT shows and game reviews on the GT Originals iOS app, available now on the App Store.